go in your vajayjay, okay? You're gonna go in your vajayjay, they're gonna come out, and they're gonna be like, bye! And they're gonna turn around and gonna walk out your life, okay?
I tell him eat the cookie cause it's good form. And when he eats the cookie, he got good form. He know I don't never cheat because I'm good to him. My God, to have his baby nurses yelling push for him.
What's up, guys? It's your girl Yo-Yo back again with another video. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about my past relationship, how I got over it, and tips on how you can get past your relationship and really learn how to love yourself. I'ma just give y'all a little overview. So basically, oh, don't mind me, I'm sick. I'm real sick. Like, you can tell I'm sick, my voice sound crazy, but we gonna get into this. Alright, so I fell in love 2 years ago with this guy who I really wouldn't have expected me to have fallen in love with him. Like, he's just not who you would expect me to be with. Like, everybody was surprised at first because we were just like really, really different. We kind of rushed things. Like, we went like very to the chase. Like, at first we did start off a friendship and stuff like that, because as I said, I never really would have seen myself with him. But he went to my high school previously, and somehow I knew about him. I met him, and then we were texting on Snapchat, but on very like friendly basis. And then we started like hanging out, and we got into this relationship. It was a beautiful relationship. We were together for almost a year. We were together for 11 months. That got me so mad. I can't even say it. We were together for a year. But like, honestly, it felt like so much longer than a year. Like, we got so close. We fell in love so quick. I knew his family. He knew my family. Everybody loved each other. It was like perfect relationship. Like, we were just like relationship goals. Everybody knew about us. Everybody loved us. Well, they either loved us or hated us. But if they hated us, it was because we were just so perfect. But I'm not gonna really get into the specifics of what happened in our relationship. It just didn't work. It wasn't working out. And so basically, what I'm gonna just say is that after a very long, beautiful relationship, things just didn't work out between us, and we had a really bad breakup. So after that breakup, I was distraught. He was distraught. Like, it was really rough. And we really tried to make our relationship work, and it just wasn't working. Like, I tried to put in my all to make things work. He tried to put in his all. It was just not working. I feel like it was also a lot of like bickering, like his friends bickering in his ear, like, you know what I'm saying? So we decided to break things off, and it was very unhealthy after we broke up, because it was a lot of like, oh, why are you posting this? Why are you with her? Why are you with him? I thought you never was gonna go back to him. I thought you said don't worry about him, but you're back to him. But I'm not back to him. Like, why are you assuming stuff? Like, I'm just at a party. Like, you know what I'm saying? So everything got really, really crazy all of a sudden. And yeah, so we tried to like stay civil, but it wasn't working. We argued so much constantly. We just kept on arguing and arguing and arguing. It was just very unhealthy because we both loved each other. We just couldn't be together. Like, it was just not working. Like, we were on very different pages. We were just on complete, total, like, separate, like, thinking of our relationship. I don't know if I'm making any sense. It was very unhealthy. It was a lot of tears. It was a lot of crying. I feel like I was mourning his death, to be honest. Knock on wood, like, I don't want that to happen, but it really felt like that, because it was like I wanted him to be there. I wanted to be with him, and I knew that it was just over. He wasn't part of my life. He was just gone. So so y'all, I did try everything. Like, I tried being with other people. I tried going out to parties. It's really cold in this room, and it's making my sickness worse. I forgot how cold it was when I picked my outfit, and I'm not changing. I basically tried everything. The only good, a big good thing that came out of our breakup was that I got closer to my friends. So after a while of me just being closed off and not talking to anybody, mind you, this was my senior year when this all went down, I was able to get a lot closer with my friends, and they were really like a safe haven for me. They were just always there for me, very supportive, very encouraging and everything like that. I tried partying, I don't know if y'all heard of that song. You think I'm flying away?
Dizzy, I ran around in circles, think I made myself dizzy. I slept it away, I sexed it away, I read it away, 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 away.
But yeah, that was my song, and it really described me after the breakup. Like, I tried everything. I tried shopping it off, I tried eating it off, I tried being with other people, I tried partying, I done tried everything in the freaking book, nothing was working. I tried to write about it, I tried to cry about it, I tried to dance about it, I tried to work out, nothing was working out, like, and I tell y'all, I was so stuck on this guy, like, I was not getting over him, like, he was my one, he was it, he was it. Okay, so how do you just get over your it? So, I was just like trying to tell y'all the story so y'all gotta understand like where I come from and how hard it was for me. I honestly feel that in the whole process, the most important thing was, the main thing that I learned through the breakup itself was that I needed to learn who I was without him. Because a big factor in our breakup was me depending on him so much that it hurt, and I had to break away from that. And then once I did break away from that, I realized that I didn't know who I was. So it was very big for me, because it was just like, I was his girlfriend, I wasn't me, okay? Like, everything I did was about him, for him, to make him proud. Like, he didn't really see it. I don't even think he knew that, but it was. My whole life was revolving around him. If I was ever gonna hang out with friends, he was there with me. Because me and him, we were a package deal, and everybody just knew that. Like, unless somebody specifically, it's a girl's night. No, everybody knew that he was just part of the package. Like, legit, me and all of my friends went out, and he came with me, and he's cool with my friends. Like, I would say that is the first thing when you're trying to get over a breakup, is to just get to know yourself. You have changed in the process of being in a relationship itself. A lot of things might have changed about you. A lot of things might not make you happy. That is just very important overall, to be happy, to just go back. Take a step back. Pause. Who am I? Like, what do I want out of life? What are my goals? What am I trying to do in my life? When you're with somebody for such a long period of time and you give them your all, it's very hard to realize that you're not together anymore. You guys aren't this thing. Like, you guys aren't a unit anymore. Like, and that's something that you really gotta like, whoa, who am I? The second thing I would say is to love yourself. If you ever did anything wrong in a relationship, or if they ever did anything wrong, I feel like a very important thing is to realize that at the end of the day, we're all human. If he messed up in the relationship, or if you messed up in the relationship, it doesn't say nothing about you. It doesn't say that you're not a good person. And everybody makes mistakes, first of all. Like, as corny as it sounds, everybody makes mistakes. Nobody is perfect. And you have to recognize that. For example, if he cheated on you, that doesn't mean that you're not perfect. You're just not perfect for him, bro. You just gotta realize that not everybody is for everybody. For a certain point in time, you might be for him. Or he might be for you. But at a certain point, it's just not that. You should... Don't stay in a relationship because, oh, we've been together for 10 years. If you're not happy, why are you with him? I'm waiting. Why are you with him if he doesn't make you happy? If you try to make things work and he's not making you happy, fuck the past 2-3 years you've been with him. What about the lifetime that you have ahead of you? You're compromising your own happiness for somebody else who's not making you happy. I'm not saying if you try to talk it out, because obviously you could talk and try to make things work. But if they're not putting their all into it, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't compromise your own happiness. So that's the big thing. Don't stay with nobody just because you've been in it for a long time. Nah. Cut that out right now. You need to make yourself happy. That's also the main thing just in general in life. Always make sure that you are happy. The choices that you make should be about you, because at the end of the day, you are the only one that has yourself. All right, he don't got you the way that you got you. If you don't got you that hard, you need to get yourself that hard. You know what I'm saying? Fuck. You gotta love yourself. Surround yourself by people that will genuinely make you happy. Surround yourself by people that are healthy, people that are fun to be around, people that are gonna remind you of your worth. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's so important to be surrounded by genuine, loving people, because that itself is going to make you happier. Not right away, but in the long run. And if there aren't any genuine people in your life, cut them the fuck out. You don't need them. Trust me, you don't. Sometimes your own company is your best company. But if you do have those couple of people that are really worth it and that will really be there for you, surround yourself with them a lot more often. Something else that helped me get over my breakup was focusing on me. I took more hours at work because I didn't want to be home and think about him. I did more activities at school. I was killing it in school too. Like, I was really putting my all into my schoolwork because I didn't want to think about him. I wanted to think about anything but him. And at the end of the day, it was a good thing. Like, my grades went up. I was doing better at work. People weren't bothering me as much as work. I was getting there. You know what I'm saying? You have to really work on these things. It's not going to happen overnight. And that's very important to realize that growth doesn't happen overnight. Change doesn't happen overnight. You're not going to get over him overnight. And it's okay. Okay, my next point. It is a-okay to cry. It's okay to cry now. It's okay to cry and bawl over that nigga. Like, it's okay. It's gonna help you. Like, I don't know how I could stress it out. Hold on. It's okay. Like, it's totally okay to cry over a guy. Like, honestly, like, when I cry, all my emotions just come out, and I feel like things get better when I just cry. When I just cry it out, because, like, all those balled up emotions, they just come out. And it feels so good to, if you have somebody's shoulder to cry on, if you have a pillow to cry on, if you got a teddy bear that you need to go ahead and buy and cry on, and just cry on his shoulder, go ahead and do so, because I'm telling you, like, it matters. Like, it's great to just cry it out. I'm telling y'all right now, just cry it out. Getting over somebody is not easy. It's not gonna come in 1, 2, 3. Back to my point, it's just like, do things to occupy your time. Maybe go back to church. Honestly, going to church made such a huge difference in my life overall, not just in my emotional health when it came to the breakup, but it brought so many blessings to my life, because you're surrounded by genuine people who care about you, want to see you succeed, and want to see you do good in the name of God. And that itself was great for me to get over that breakup. It brought so much peace to my life. There's so many ways that you can cope. You can write about it, you can dance about it, you can let out your emotions in a dance piece, but always, the main thing is remember your worth. Remember who you are, and remember that you're important. You're valuable. You mean so much. You might not know it, but it should mean so much to so many people. You have so much to look forward to. Don't time is so valuable. Don't let one guy distract you from what you want to do. Set goals for yourself. You know what I'm saying? When you distract yourself, you stop thinking about that person that they either hurt you or you just want to be with them so bad. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's so important to just get over that and be you. Sometimes when you put work into yourself, it manifests itself and you see growth. And after a while, you don't even realize it, but you're over that person. And for every person, getting over that one person is very different across the board. And again, I'm not saying it's easy, but it will come, okay? It will come. The time will come when you'll be able to say, I'm finally over that person. Having sex with other people is really not that healthy. Okay, it's not gonna do much, because a lot of people nowadays, they just want to be there for a good time. I mean, I say I'm not here for a long time, I'm here for a great time. No, don't have sex with people to get over one person. Okay, if you're gonna have sex with people, have sex with people that will make you feel better. If you're gonna feel bad because they don't respond to you in a week, don't have sex with them. Okay, there's very few people who will come in your life and stay in your life, and there's that very closely relates to penis. Okay, penis will come in your life. Hey, what's up? I wanna be here for the rest of your life. I wanna make everything better, and then they're gonna go in your vajayjay. Okay, they're gonna go in your vajayjay. They're gonna come out and they're gonna be like, bye, and they're gonna turn around and gonna walk out your life. Okay, but yeah, that is so unhealthy to like have sex with people to get over somebody. It's so unhealthy. Don't do it. Trust me. Don't do it. If you have that one person that you can just always like mess around with, that is honest. That'll be great. Go out, experience life. Have fun. Do things that you never thought you would ever do before. Love yourself. I can't stress enough. Love yourself. You are great. You are beautiful. You are wonderful. If nobody has told you today, you are amazing, okay? I love you. If nobody has said that to you, I love you, okay? Okay? Whew. My hair actually looks cute down. It just didn't look that cute when I was upstairs with the shadows. Okay. Alright, you guys. So, thank you guys so much for watching my video. I really love and appreciate you guys. I love you. If you haven't heard this today, I love you. And you are loved. And my highlighter is messed up from the front because it's not a highlighter. It's an eyeshadow. And I keep thinking this is a good one, but it's a bad one. But it's okay. It's okay because I love myself. So, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to sub to my channel if you haven't done so already. Come on, you know. You know you want to. You know you want to. You know you want to. It's up here somewhere. It's up here somewhere. Just sub to. If you're already sub, thank you so much for supporting me so much to me. Like this video. Give it a thumbs up. Comment any content you want to see. My channel is about to blow up. I'm 1 week away from going to temple, and there's so much happening. It's the first week of spring. It's about to get crazy. It's about to get lit, y'all. We want to have a good time because I'm going to be vlogging all of these videos. So, yeah, I have some good content coming up soon. Just wait on it. Let me know if you like these types of videos so I can do more of them. I know I talk a lot. So, do you guys like me talking this much? Let me know. Let me know. Let me know in the comments down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much. Peace. See you in my next video. Peace. I still can't get that shit right. Can somebody teach me how to do that? I can't do it right for nothing. You guys.